Hi, my dear Aries. Welcome to your reading for January 2018 by Maya. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. Welcome to your reading. First of all, I want to wish you all the best in the new 2018 year. I wish you wealth, health, happiness, success, love, and anything that you wish yourself. So let's see what is coming for you in the month of January 2018. It looks like first week of the January is going to be slow progress. There's going to be some creative block that is going on and slow progress. Be careful of overspending the money in the week of first week of January. It's time to nurture yourself. So take care of yourself before you're taking care of others. Before you're thinking about others, think about yourself. Nurture yourself. So this was the week one. The second week you have strength card, another major arcana card reversed. This energy is gonna go all through the month because it's major arcana card. This card is telling you that maybe you're looking for help and solving problems in some places other than yourself. It tells you instead of looking for somebody else to solve your problems, take the matter in your own hands. Listen to your intuition and your intellect as well, and in regards to relationship, this card suggested you to show your feeling to your loved ones. You may be surprised what is going to come out of it. Don't be shy, that's okay. You just like go ahead, try, see what is going on, what is going to happen. So the third week, you have again reverse card, but it's not major arcana. You have six of pentacles that is reversed. And this Six of Pentacles tells you that it's okay to ask for help if you need help in some area of your life. And it's okay to help others too. They're going to be appreciate your help if you can help to them. In regards to financial situation, this card suggested you not to be careful. Where are you getting, what things are you getting involved? Where are you putting your money? What are you investing, right? In regards to the relationship, it tells you again to focus on give and take, to support each other in relationship in order to get closer and open yourself, your feeling, tell exactly how you feel. So the last week is promising, it's much better than the first. So it's fire, you have the fire, Ace of Wands. It's new start, new beginning. Whatever you was thinking that you're gonna start, you're gonna do, maybe relationship, maybe job, maybe something else, maybe you're gonna buy something, you're gonna travel somewhere, whatever you was planning to do, but you wasn't sure, or am I gonna do or not? This card tells you, yes, go ahead. It's green light for you. Do that, go ahead. So it's some of you may have like, start some passionate, romantic, joyful relationship with some other person. It's gonna be more committed and loyal than it was before. It's a time for you really to dream big and use this energy of the card to get whatever you was planning to do, but you was not sure about that. So go ahead, green light is there on for you. It looks like good. There is another card from which tarot card deck that tells you more about situation, what is like, gives more light to current situation, what is going on and how to fix that, what you're supposed to know about that, right? In order to get most of the week of the reading. This creative block that you have experienced, maybe you're not focusing on the things that you was doing before, not doing much in that area, but there is another card that tells you there is success, right? There is victory. This is card of victory, success. It's good fortune card. Some people are gonna get financial success. Some of them you're gonna may have job promotion. Some of you may have love, like new love coming or old one getting much more like connected deeper, and there is happiness, love, and cooperation. I saw this card tells you the world is full of pleasant surprises. So if you have some block experience starting of the week, that is for some reason that the universe works for you, bringing you more luck and love and happiness in life, success. So the second card, the Strength, and the crown. So let's see, we hear the crown is about overcoming obstacles. If this was reversed, right, so now it's time to take control of the situation. It's about self-discipline and perseverance, to take responsibility for your own problems. Everything occurs in divine timing, right? So it's overcoming obstacles and taking control of your life and your situation. And the more light on the strip week is gonna be nature, 15 card nature. This card tells you to think about long-term goals, right? If you need help, ask God for help. If you wanna give help somebody else, it's okay. It's a good idea to do that. But it's about think about longer-term goals and see where you're having barrier in your life. What is holding you back? Who is that? What person? Examine what person or thing are holding you on a chain. This is kind of devil card. Reevaluate that and be aware to avoid those people and situation, so you can free yourself from those binding and get free. If you need help, you can ask for help. Some people that are professional in the area. And so the last week we have four Artemis and with Ace of Wands. This is time, the water that it was, that was going on for you, it's time for kind of having some break, some rest. You may withdraw from situation and meditate, but go on with whatever you was planning to do. It's kind of confusing stuff, because one is go on, another one is like a kind of resting. Maybe you have to find out more in deep what you want, and before you proceed further. Sometimes this is kind of going to for vacation, getting some quiet time, working for yourself, clarify things. So anyway, this is going to be taking care of yourself and finding what you want and go on with that. So let's see, clarified for the first week is Ace of Water. With those two cards, we have Ace of Water. With Empress and Pentacles, we have Ace of Water. This card, Ace of Water, tells you, have the message for you. It tells you, I am filled with love that gives me hope, shining brilliant light on all the possibilities available to me. So there are so many possibilities available for you. Okay, so if you're not working in one area, you're going in another, progressing in another area. So one is stagnation, another one is getting up. In second week, we have 10 of Earth. And there is another message of 10 of Earth. 10 of Earth is affluence, card of affluence. And it tells you, I'm able to step back and observe the results of what I built through my dedication and hard work. So it's success, it's affluence. That would be second week. And the third week we have clarified High Priestess. The High Priestess with those cards. With the Devil and Six of Pentacles reversed, we have High Priestess. Not all things can be like revealed same way. There is sometimes by meditation, by higher self, by another realm that you can information in your life that you can use and gain clarity. High priest is there is message. Time when my mysteries will be revealed and I can grow as a result. So your mysteries will be revealed and you can grow as a result. trust yourself to have higher wisdom, right? It's about high priestess. And the last week we have with those cards we have a page of earth. There is visible success that is going on. There is message for you from page of earth. Everything starts with a plan, and I am beginning to see results generate prosperity. I have ability to attract whatever I want. So whatever you want, whatever you're planning, go ahead, you're going to do that. Clarify what you want to do and go ahead. So it's supporting card, good fortune. Let's see what is the, for overall, for major arcana cards, for overall month, for the whole month, there is going to be Hanged Man. The Hanged Man tells you that trust that everything will work out as it needs. So everything is going to go fall out in place. The universe is on work, right? Trust that everything will work out as it needs. So this is a major arcana card for this month. And by mistake, I get two more cards. And I want to see what is that about. There is another message for you. There is one King Knight of Wands. They said for you, good news. Move forward, go for it. Whatever you was planning, it's okay for you to start to doing that, to work on that. It's possible relocation in regard to money. You may get experience change in the money for better. And in the work, you may get promotion or transfer or maybe some kind of trip. In terms of love, you can have some enjoyable affairs. And this card tells you, is it time for action? So there is another card that I pulled out by mistake, and that is the battle wagon. You're gonna balance your stuff in this month. It's gonna be in balance, like slowly balancing, getting in order. There is card of victory, and there is message. All my life experience are now part of my victory. So all whatever you have gained through your life now is part of your victory. It's gonna be part, and it is. So this is the reading for you for the month of January 2018. I have an announcement that I'm not gonna be able to offer private reading, what I said before in December, because of technical reasons. As soon as I fix that, I'll give you notice about that. I'll put on my website, on my on YouTube, so you're gonna find out when it's gonna be offered private reading. For now, we're gonna stay with this. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. I hope this is gonna help you in the month of January to use the best your energies and whatever is there for you. If you like this, you can subscribe. There is a link down below. Don't forget to like it. Don't forget to share. So see you next month. Bye for now.